event, you know, I just looked at Elvis as a rock. He would always be there. You know, some people in this world, you can't imagine the world without, and I never thought about him dying. You know, when he walked in the bathroom, he's 42 years old. You don't die at 42, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And it was such a devastating and tragic day, and, you know, I had to be... I felt descriptive, which was very difficult to do, but I had to be descriptive because
I've
seen quite a few untruths in other books, even on the very day he died, and how he was found and all this. And I said, I can't let that sit out as the truth. That's not what happened.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's why I wrote, and as difficult as it was, it had to be done. So I wrote about it. And But yeah, to this day, it's you know, it was such a shock and such a sad... that event.
Sure. You mentioned as you were riding in the funeral procession, you saw a person taking a picture of the funeral procession driving by. You know who I'm speaking about?
Caroline Kennedy.
Yes. I was amazed by that. Yeah. Could you tell us who you saw out the window?
Well, I just thought it was odd that I looked up. It bothered me. I remembered being in the limousine, and I didn't want to, when I saw the masses and the people lining the street, it just hit me, and I remembered looking down at the floorboard and for a little bit, and I just glanced up, and I looked in this crowd of people, and I saw this woman. Looked like she quickly took a picture, turned, and it registered with me. That looked like Caroline Kennedy. And later, sure enough, you know, I found out she had come to Graceland. But I remember thinking how odd that I would look up at that moment and see her face in the, that I would, you know.
Yeah, and boy, she's gone through. She knows what you were going through.
Oh, right? Absolutely.
Yeah. You wrote a very lovely poem in your book. It's included. And I love the line, the clever line, "I'll walk up very gingerly." And for the listeners who haven't had a chance yet to by the book Elvis and Ginger, check out the beautiful poem that Ginger Alden wrote. I just wanted to mention that to you, Ginger, that I really loved the poem that you included. It was very, really touching and really nicely written.
Thank you, Steve. I appreciate it. It was, it was something I wanted to do, and little note to him, I guess, so
mm-hmm.
to say.
Yeah. Well, before we say goodbye, I want to let you know, listeners, the book written by Ginger is nothing but class all the way. Really, Ginger, you didn't shun away from the tough things that happened, like I said, with Elvis's passing and things like that, but it was class all the way, and I really appreciate you clearing up so many things that those of us who loved Elvis and love you now that we got to know you so much better as well. You had a career, you sang a great song. You were in a movie, and your song, "I'd Rather Have a Memory Than a Dream," I'd like to finish with that song. What can you tell us about your kind of career after Elvis, quickly, modeling and singing and acting?
Well, yes, I moved from Memphis, and I moved up to New York City, I believe in 1980, and I started a career. Fortunately, I was able to model. I was tall enough at the time. Now the girls are quite a bit taller. I'm short, I guess.
How the heck with them?
You know, I went forward, yeah, and made a living, and moved up to the city, and I went out for pilot season a few times out to California and lived out there briefly, and moved back to New York City. But, I worked for a good, 15, 16 years until I got pregnant with my son, and then I raised him.
Mm-hmm. And people can find you on Facebook. Is it Ginger Alden Questions? I'm sorry, I should know.
Yes, I do have a question, but I do have my personal page, but I have a like page and question and answer.
And of course, the book, Elvis and Ginger, you can get it all the usual, Amazon.com, all the usual places, right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Well, Ginger, I'll tell you, everyone, you won't read a classier author than Ginger Alden. She just told a loving story of Elvis. You're going to love Elvis more. You'll love Ginger Alden. And all I can tell you is thank you so much for spending some time with us, Ginger. It's really appreciated.
Well, I appreciate it so much. Thank you, Steve.
Okay, all the best. Happy holidays.
Bye-bye.
I'd rather have a memory than a dream. I'd rather look back on the good times I've seen. memory.
Rather have a memory
than a dream.
Rather have a memory than a dream.
People tell me you'll break my heart and make me cry. But I want to live just a little.
That was the last single release before Elvis's untimely death, Way Down. Now, we're not done yet. Guys, we have I'm going to play a couple more Elvis songs for you before we end things. And I want to thank Ginger Alden for such a wonderful, lovely interview. She is a beautiful person inside and out.
And check out her book, buy her book, Elvis and Ginger. There's so much in the book that we didn't even mention during our conversation. So if you haven't already bought the book, buy it. You'll love it. It's really something else. I want to remind you, everybody, next week, our guest, Stanley Livingston from My Three Sons. And Stanley is also an accomplished artist, producer, of course, in addition to being an actor. So that's next week. And that'll do it, everybody. But, like I said, we're going to play a couple Elvis songs for you. And let's see, I'm trying to think, how could I end our show about Elvis? And I thought, let me play two of my favorite Elvis songs, one ballad and one rocker. Now, if you talk to me next week, these could change because I love so many Elvis songs, right? So hard to choose. But we're going to say goodbye with first my favorite Elvis ballad, followed by my favorite Elvis up-tempo song. And everybody, thank you so much. We love you for listening. We'll catch you next week. And until then, long live the king.
Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you.
Number